The aftermath of yet another attack on a Russian journalist. This CCTV footage shows radio host Tatiana Felgenhauer just seconds after this man stormed into the studio and stabbed her in the neck. The victim's boss, Alexei Venediktov, the head of Echo Radio, which released the video, blames Russian authorities for failing to stop violence against reporters and fueling hatred of independent and critical media.
State media journalists get killed in military zones, and journalists working for media that is not controlled by the Kremlin die in Moscow, St. Petersburg, and Novosibirsk. They are being attacked and injured, and the authorities, in my opinion, enable this by not investigating these cases.
In this case, the suspect, Boris Gritz, came to Russia from Israel. He's not yet entered a plea. Russian authorities say he's mentally unstable, leading the Kremlin to brush off any notion of government-sanctioned hostility towards journalists.
What does freedom of speech have to do with this? A sick person arrived from Israel and attacked this journalist. Echo Moscow is funded by the government. Nothing like that even exists in the world.
Echo Radio is owned by Russia's state oil giant Gazprom, but is known for broadcasts critical of the government. There is a troubled history of violence against journalists in Russia, many harassed and some even killed. The most prominent was investigative reporter Anna Politkovskaya, who was gunned down in the lobby of her apartment building in 2006. She worked for this publication, Novaya Gazeta, which holds its meeting under the pictures of six of its reporters who were killed doing their jobs. Now, their chief editor, Dmitry Muratov, is saying enough is enough and wants to arm his reporters.
I know that my statement caused a lot of controversy. Some people thought it's a metaphor, but it is not a metaphor, as the government cannot protect journalists, and we lost six people to murders. We made a decision to provide them with means of self-defense.
He says he hoped Russian authorities would feel pressured by his announcement and pledge to better protect journalists. Instead, two Russian gun makers offer the paper a discount on easy-to-use weapons. Novaya Gazeta's management says despite the risks, they won't compromise their journalism.
We participate in global investigations. We fight corruption, and our journalists go to war zones. We achieve a lot because when civil society is given open and truthful information, it starts to demand certain measures from the authorities.
Tatiana Felgenhauer showed her will to carry on. 2 weeks after getting stabbed, she was back on the air against the will of her doctors and her boss, refusing to be silenced, hoping she won't be attacked for doing her job again. Fred Pleitgen, CNN, Moscow.